It's the end of the year. It's end of year tax planning. Three things you can do right now to prepare. That's today's episode. Let's dive into it. Hey everyone, I'm Clayton Morris.
I'm Natalie Morris.
We're both longtime real estate investors and we're kind of tax nerds. Well, she's more of a tax nerd than I am, but I get super excited about how we can actually save on our taxes by the end of the year. It's the end of the year. This channel is devoted to helping you become financially intelligent and financially free. We want to help you build passive income every month using buy and hold real estate. That's what we do. So even if you don't use real estate or buy and hold real estate, there are some other great tax things that you can plan for as the end of the year approaches.
That's right. Now, if you're new to this show, it may be news to you that real estate is an amazingly tax-friendly investment. If you're not new to the show and you haven't picked that up by now, I'm going to hit you in the head with my shoe.
Yeah, or are you hiding under a rock?
Right.
Real estate is the number one tax vehicle. And we've had Tom Wheelwright here on the show. You've got to check out Tom's interviews, of course, because as Tom points out, even under the new tax law that was passed back in 2018, there are even more benefits for real estate investors under the new tax code.
Absolutely right. So we are going to do this show under the assumption, it's an empirical fact, that real estate is very tax-friendly way to invest your money. But you want to be prepared for taxes. You don't want this surprise. Oh, that's sort of how I used to be, is I would give all my paperwork to an accountant in like February or March and then just cross my fingers for, you know, however
like
many weeks.
Yeah.
Like, okay, let's see what happens. That's not how we do it anymore. Once we became serious real estate investors, we are year-round tax planning. In fact, when we started working with Tom Wheelwright's company, we sort of said, okay, you know, I think it was the beginning of the year. We had saved up a bunch of money to work with them. And then they said, well, we're not going to file your taxes this year, but we're going to start tax planning and we'll pick it up next year. And I was like, what? And they're like, no, tax planning is a constant pursuit. But if you haven't been in that constant pursuit and you find yourself in December, do some things now so that you are not burned in April and thought, oh, I could have done this, that, or the other, right?
All right. So first on our list for things you can do right now at the end of the year to plan for taxes, step one, what is number one on our list?
Okay. You should have an estimate of how much you are going to report in earned income from real estate investments. This should not be a surprise to you. Most of the time you get rental statements, right? With that number, now you know what you're going to be taxed on, and then you have a few weeks to mitigate those taxes. If you don't know that until January 1st, I'm also going to hit you on the head with my shoe.
Don't get hit on the head with her shoe. I've been there. Step one is estimate your earnings. Get a good handle on what you're looking at. Now, Natalie does a lot of this for us. She's a spreadsheet crazy person. So step one, estimating earnings. You're looking at this throughout the year. You and I have a monthly meeting to go over our portfolio, to look at houses that, okay, this one's in eviction. This one's vacant right now. We've got a tenant turnover. What do we can expect? So how can people who are watching this get set up for success by estimating their earnings?
Well, most of the time you can look at your statements from January to November. You find yourself in December, you know whether or not you're collecting rent that month. So that's pretty easy to do. If you use QuickBooks, even better on ya. If you use Mint, right, it's not that hard to know how much have you earned this year. And so that's what you're going to report to the government. Now, obviously, the beginning of 2018, we saw this new tax law pass. So a lot of this now, if you're investing in an LLC, which again, if you're not doing, I'm threatening a lot of violence today, but you should know this stuff by now, then you are getting another tax break in how you're getting that money, because pass-through LLCs get this extra tax benefit, right? So these are things that you should know because you've been tracking them all year. This, and now you know, I'm going to report income of $10,000 of rent this year, right? None of that rent has been taxed. So obviously you're on the line for it, right? So there are things you can do between the end of now and the end of the year to maybe make sure that you're lowering your taxes even more, right? The next thing that we want to talk to you about is depreciation.
Yeah, step two on this list is depreciation and getting a handle on what you are going to depreciate in your rental portfolio. Now, if you've got a large rental portfolio like we do, this is where a cost segregation could come into play. Please watch our show on cost segregations. This is where you hire a professional CPA who is certified in cost segregations. They'll go out to your properties and they will depreciate not just the house itself, which is what it used to be able to do, mm-hmm. but they'll actually depreciate the roof, the windows, different items in the house. It's especially useful for large-scale commercial investors. But if you're a residential retail investor, a residential property investor like we are, small single-family homes, it might not be worth it to do a cost segregation because you're going to pay a few thousand dollars to this CPA. However, for them to fly into town and all of that, if you've got multiple properties, that's where it can come into view for you. But even without a cost segregation, depreciation is powerful.
Right. So you want to make sure you have a CPA who is going to tell you what you can depreciate and what you can claim this year. If you have someone who does not specialize in real estate, you're not on the right track. You need someone who really understands how to accelerate your depreciation. But also, you're going to depreciate assets like a computer or a car, or, you know, those things have their own rules. So can you make a purchase of a computer that then lowers your tax basis this year? Do you need something like a printer? Well, that's not very much. You could buy a server or something like that, right? So make your capital expenditures in this calendar year. Now, we did do a whole episode on cost segregation, which you can look. We should probably do one in January again because this is like magic trick. Mm-hmm. But I want to say to you that you can accelerate your depreciation in the year you buy something. So let's say that you say, oh my gosh, I'm going to pay taxes on $10,000. I don't want to do that. So I'm going to buy another rental property December 15th, right? Mm-hmm. And get that closed before the end of the year. Awesome. Okay. Now, you can do a cost segregation on that property and claim all of that depreciation on your 2018 taxes, but you don't have to do the cost segregation in the year 2018. You actually have till September of 2019 to do the cost segregation. So buy the property now, do the cost segregation. Our guy doesn't like to do it when it's frozen outside. Right. So he's like, I'll do it in the spring when everything thaws out. So then hire him to go in March and do your cost segregation. It takes him a couple of weeks. And then you can put that depreciation on your taxes in April. Or if you didn't get it done in time, you can put it on your taxes in September. Mm-hmm. But the point is, you buy it in this year.
Right.
Makes sense?
Yeah. No, it makes total sense. Even though the tax code makes people mad, this is why you get a good tax accountant who understands real estate investing. That's very, very important if you're a real estate investor to get a tax accountant that understands it, right?
Right.
Yeah, that's why our phone rings off the hook in December in the Morris Invest offices, because so many people, like, they're like, hey, you got to buy a property at the end of the year. And so December for us in our office is like a madhouse. I mean, right. You know, and our title companies are like scrambling to get closings done before the end of the year. We had one last year where there was like, oh my God, our title company had closed. The title agent had like taken the paperwork home with her just to get this closing done for one of our clients in order to make it happen.
Yeah.
So that happens. All right. Step three in this process, you kind of alluded to it, which is though to secure any big purchases right now before the end of the year. This is why a lot of people, again, not only buy real estate at the end of the year, but buy that computer. Mm-hmm. If you have an LLC that owns your rental properties, you're running a business. You are in business. So if there are any big purchases that can help you be a better investor, like that car that's going, you know, driving around looking for properties or whatever it happens to be, make those big purchases right now.
Exactly right. Because of course, computer equipment depreciates. Mm-hmm. My father, he owns a landscape company, and his tractors and loaders and golf carts that they put the sprinkler equipment, all that stuff depreciates at different rates. And you want that depreciation. It's like a magical, like, poof, we give you money for this because we know it's worth less this year. It's awesome. You must get a handle on your depreciation and then buy things that you can depreciate, or buy things that can lower your tax basis and get that done.
Yeah,
we also like to pay our CPA and our legal fees in this calendar year. So a lot of times I'll say, okay, can you give me an estimate of what you're going to charge me for April so that I have it on the books in this year? And then if they go over, I can pay more, right? But at least I've take in that deduction in this calendar year too.
Yeah, smart stuff. Tax strategies, year-end planning. Have a wonderful holiday season, everyone. Save some money on taxes. We'll see you next time here on the channel that helps you create financial freedom. Much love to you. We'll see you next time.